Hi, friends of golfers. Erik Solberg. Today, I want to go over kind of the comprehensive golf swing help for either beginners or maybe those struggling, okay? You know, talking rep, posture, alignment, we're going to get into some low point too. You'll be amazed how much these will help you if these are your problems or not rotating correctly. The golf game can become simpler than we think if we're doing some of these things correct, okay? So let's talk about grip first. What I'm going to go over is my experience in all the years of golf that I see as there's definitely correlations and typicals that I see with bad everything. So grip or whatever, it's not like, oh, I see 50-50 of this. There's definitely a huge trend. The trend always is this. It's more grabbing in the palm and kind of almost in the middle like this. So the problem with that on your lead hand is look how my wrist does it. Well, you know, you get people, I end up like this and just no power. So I call this part of my hand right here on the lead hand the meaty part of my hand. If that part has to get on top of the grip. You see how I'm grabbing it right here? Now that's on top. Now, I'm going to pull this thing up in front of me. Now, when I look at it, now I'm going to look. If I look straight down, I'm going like this. It's so hard for my students to do that when I ask them. They're like, don't move your head, but look how many knuckles you can see there. I go, But if I look down, I see 2 to 3. And most people need to see that. Are there those out there that play with the weak grip? And yes, there are. Most people, though, would benefit from having this because their wrist smile, if you watch them function, look at that movement. So I can go up like this nice rotation, it just moves naturally. This is how the club should naturally move, okay? Just like that, okay? Now, you got that on there, right hand. I'd use this kind of shaking hands and putting it on here. Some may have a little more under, some may be a little more on top. I would say since most people slice, I'd have it a tad bit more under. It's just gonna help you get this club face a little more closed. That's grip, rotation. I see it huge. I'll just see these swings that are just like arms, that's it. It definitely does break down. Maybe the body moves a little bit, but then you get to, it's like everybody's parallel, but look at my body, didn't even move. So that person should really be here. I think of it like this when you're working a rotation, a nice rotation, but thinking of the hands as far away from our body as possible, okay? So body kind of turns, or feel like the hands get as far away from as possible. So I'm just going to do this rotational drill here. When you get a nice turn, just like that, and then I would take the thumb and put it out here. And this is what I want you to feel, this huge pull. Now these stash lines right here, you're going to be feeling this huge pull I got here. In fact, that's what I feel in my takeaway, this huge pull from this side that just pulls everything back and gets me nice and tight. So guess what happens? Then I unwind. The backswing is a setup that we kind of, I call it bounce off of to unwind with, okay? Nice turn where you feel that left shoulder. If I had something 4 feet away in the ground for me right here, I'd see this club here pointing about at that, okay? So it'd be a little bit outside the ball. I don't want people like this. I don't want them flat like that. So we're right about here, okay? And the other thing you hear all the time is this left arm, okay? You got to keep this left arm straight. Problem with that is this is what people do. They get this thing way behind them, something like that. Folks, don't worry about your left arm. If you turn your body, this left arm is going to be fine. It's not going to want to go like this. You're not going to have the support you need, okay? I would think more about this right arm. Be like that thing is more straight, okay? That way we have the width we want. Most people collapse it like this. You won't see a single person on 2 hour pass 90 degrees, okay? I think Bubba may, but I kind of leave Bubba out of it. So, but typically you'll see Rory with his driver about 60, so it's really, really wide. So I tend to think more of just get your body turning, and this stuff's all going to be out here as long as we're thinking about keeping, like I said, the hands away from our head. We don't want anything close to us. We don't want to be here, close to our ear, close to our shoulder. We want to be away from us, okay? Basically getting this RE, a tank, not below our chest, not on above our chest, above our pec, okay? So you get turned. Now, what things go wrong too is if we have improper alignments, okay? Now, I'm not going to get into saying everybody needs the same alignment, okay? Depending on your swing, I have some people open, some people closed, but here's the point, okay? Whatever you are, that needs to stay consistent, because if I am a little bit open, okay? And so if I'm like that one day, I'm a little bit open right here, and my swing feels pretty, you know, like normal from that point. What happens if I end up, now I'm going to really get like this. So this feels normal now. What do I have to do to get that ball over there? I'm going to have to come up simply, get it way underneath like this to get it to the same spot. Or if I'm closed, I'm going to have to do something crazy like this to get it back over. The thing is, it's going to be so gradual, you won't even know until your beam's gone really downhill. You'll be like, what happened? How am I swinging it so far? We swing it usually typically along our body lines. So if for some reason you're a little open or square or a little closed, it doesn't, you know, I have preferences based on your swing, which one to do, but whatever you come up with, stick with it, and that will breed consistency in your golf swing, okay? The other point that seems to be misconstrued always is low point. Now, low point, when you have a track man like I do, and you can see the statistics up here, the numbers, track man is basically giving me a snapshot of what's happening out here. I get some stuff that happens from here to here, but most of it's a snapshot of what is right, what happens when I hit it. So low point is this: when we hit the golf ball, okay, our lowest point should be like 45 inches in front. Now what happens is, just I think because nobody's told, they just assume it's at the golf ball, so we get a lot of flipping like this trying to end it right there. So you get these high weak shots, you never compress it. Like, in order to compress this ball, we gotta have our hands ahead, we probably catch on the third groove, and we're driving down at a negative angle attack, so maybe like 5 degrees with a 7-iron, allowing us the chance to really compress it. So the way to work on that is pretty simple. I like to think, so if I'm at the ball right here, I'll set my club here, okay? Get yourself a nice backswing, and then work on landing up here, okay? So probably, you know, 4 or 5 inches in front. And once you do that a few times, go ahead and hit it. Okay, posture. I want to go over that really quick too. So I've done a lot of videos on this. Most people come in, they're like this. Hips are way back. We're kind of on our heels. So you see, if I put this in the middle of my hip, it's way behind my heel. What's wrong with that? I can't move. I told this. I just can't turn. Okay. So I want to feel like if I put this in the middle, it's going to be more over my ankle. Okay. And then I'm going to have a little bit around the back, and I'm going to feel like my pose is more underneath me. Not that much, but just a little bit. Okay. My upper back's going to be a little bit rounded. The arm going to kind of fall right there, and that's where I'm at. Okay, that's what I want to feel. Why is that important? This allows me to really wind up and the body work as it's meant to be. Okay, so I can get down in this kind of impact zone like I want right here. So when I'm coming through, I want to be able to be here, hit about third groove down, and land here. Work on those. Like I said, most of them are static, meaning before you even hit, but then I want you also working on this drill. If you just do this drill working on low point, you're going to improve your game. The final thing I want to cover is this, is the other part I find that most people don't know with golf is this. I have two ways to close this club face, okay? One of them is this. I can take my backswing and I can go like this, right? Which is called basically flipping, right? But it closes my club face, right? And if you look from this end, it'd be somebody that goes like this. So my hands are way back here, and then I'm like this. Oh, typically, their hands are behind the ball when they hit it. Okay, there's no shaft lead. But what will it do? It'll get the club face square, typically, okay? What we want to do is learn to rotate this shaft, motorcycle move, like that. If you watch the club face when I do this, close. So if I do this, look what happens on the way down. And so this club face is more closed, and then I just rotate and turn, so that I end up like this. Look at that, hands way ahead. That's what I want. So work on some drills where you split your grip like this, go up a little bit like that, and I want you to just come down real slow, down like this, where the ball would be. That's where your hands are, and you find out that's gonna be massive compression. Just to get used to this feeling of what it's like to control a club. Just a good idea for you is we want to remove the extension you have on your left wrist on the way down, basically flatten it. If we do that, we'll see how it's starting to match my back angle by the time I get here. That's what we want. We'll be in real good shape typically if we can just get this pretty flat on the way down. Sometimes I'm leaving a little bowed, that's okay too. As long as we're working that way out of this extension towards flexion, we're in good shape. That's a big start to your golf career, or to help you get out of a funk if you're in it. Typically when something goes wrong in your golf game, if you even experience this, you're gonna find it in something I just talked about. It doesn't mean typically that, oh, I gotta go into this deep analysis of what could be here and there. For most golfers, it's hiding something in there, okay? Now, it could be something else, especially for the beginner. And those of you struggling, knock all those out as possibility. Once you've done that, then you can move on and see if it's something else. I hope this helps you. Erik, EJS Golf Academy.